Hello subscribers. Now you like my new jacket? I've made it myself. Put in the comments. And let me start today. Today I want to talk about the military and what I think about the military and war. Actually, I think I'm a little bit different about war than most people. I think war is a bunch of young people that protect old man's property. Old man's, old rich man's, or old rich woman's property. I think the only people that go in war be miserable fools that have nothing to be proud of. And in order for their own insecurity, go to war. There is no glory in fighting for somebody else's property to protect. There is no, absolutely no glory in that. As long as people will murder other animals, as long as humans will murder each other and go to war for some oil, or some religious things, or some business things, people will not have the liberty on this planet. War will go and go, because that's where the most wars go. War, go, money, oil, suck the whole world dry. That's only where the rich Republicans, puppet masters, give about. They give only about put your children to war to turn them in dead soldiers. That's only where all the leaders of the world give about. No, they give nothing about you or about your families. They want you children dead. That's what they want. They want that your children go in war so that your children become their protectors of their money. Testosterone! One of the most interesting hormones if it comes to aggression and do stupid things. I think most men being stupid, and I think that most women be crazy, and the main reason that most women be crazy is that most men be stupid. Go fighting to each other only for a piece of land that even in the first place not belongs to them. The whole planet belongs not to the humans. The whole planet belongs to the other animals, the ants, the birds, the monkeys, the chimpanzees, so like also the gorillas, the orangutans, the lions, all other animals. We've been just like a sick, psychotic house guest that don't can even live with each other. And for all the other religion folks that watch now this video, think you that God be so proud of you that I think that all these soldiers are you or in the religion soldiers that all these that the God be on all the sides of all these soldiers can be being that God is on the side of one of you, that God is not with you. That God is with his creations in all, that God is not only for America or China or Iraq. No, God is on the people that live in harmony with the planet and with other animals. I think even if you've been an atheist, God is more on your side if you've been vegan. Because God lived not in books. God lived not in the holy wall. God lived not in a piece of paper, in a flag. God living as creations. God living the animals, the planets, and in other humans. So if you murder the planets, if you destroy other species, if you don't live in harmony with the rules of or dependence on other species, you don't be important for them. Only what humans do is take and take and take and take a little bit more, like the most biggest parasite that have ever lived in this planet. War don't make anything good. War on anything. This is what it's been, people. I say you now, all the religions people and all the religious soldiers that believe in war, that it makes something great. Great, not make not. There is no nobility in protecting rich people or protecting bloodsuckers. There is nobility in fighting for the poor, and there is a nobility in fighting for the innocents, for the victims. You maybe don't see yourself like a victimizer, but it don't mean that you don't be one. The world give enough for anybody's needs, but not enough for anybody's greed. And as long as the world leaders don't understand that there been a limited amount of resources and that we have to share the whole planet, not with only humans, but also with other animals, they're being totally insane. All the animals, other animals, the bees, the worms, the plankton, the sharks, the whales, all the other animals that can live easily without us. We don't can live without them. So when come the day that people learn to take responsibility for their actions and stop with all this stupid, insane war games. If the worlds of the nations of all the world be so good in seeing what we right and what we wrong, as all the judges be so good in seeing what right and what we wrong, then I challenge you. Go a vegan. Because that's the only way that we can save our planet from totally damnation. Because the meat industry is the main cause of all the problems on this planet. That being the main cause of world hunger. The amount of CO2 comes from the meat industry. It's around something like 51 to 80% in this time age. The estimate has been going to the sky, and the amount of CO2 comes from all the forms of transportation together is around something like 30%. And that is what been actually. Step into reality, people. Accept it. We also, since 1950, have lost something like 90% of all our protoplankton. But that is not what the navies of the world give about. They give only about their money and the fools that want to fight for their money. Any miserable fool that have nothing to be proud of, try to find as a last resort, proud in a nation where he is born. Protect all his foolish, all his flaws, all his imperfections in order to recover himself from his self-destruction. from his own insecurity. As long as there have been slaughterhouses, there will be battlefields. That's what most war go about. Stealing ground from other nations. Being insane. Don't see the bigger picture. Because they're being totally delusional. I've been against war. Only phonies go to war. And only military, the only thing that military do. And big nations, because they have the power to bully other countries in acting like they want. It's not how the world works. You have to learn to live in harmony with the rules of dependence from other species. We have to learn to live with the rules of the World Charter for Nature. We have to learn in harmony with the rules of species diversity. And we have to stop with breeding like cockroaches and insects. We have already too much humans on this planet. The world can't have 10 billion humans. I think that is a pretty good idea also. But this is for another topic with a favorite conclusion with this to go. If we take some people the right to procreate away, that's better than to murder them. Societies don't like that, because societies give only about your money, and Republicans give only about you when you raise the time of becoming a dead soldier. As long you be not 18 years old and you can go in the military and can buy these hands of this rich pro-life people, pro-life anti-execution people. Then they give nothing about you. But if you raise that one, they can have interest in you, and then you win. That's waiting for their attention. Because they want you to go in war, protect their property. Because that is what war goes for. There's no glory in war. Just like there's no glory in murder. War is actually murder in name of the state.